every high priest taken from among men.
For every high priest taken from among men.
Is ordained of men in things pertaining to God.
Now, I want you to hear this, dude, because I wasn't scheduled to preach. But I studied and read a lot, and I ran across this scripture, and it's talked about the high priest. Read.
That he may offer both gifts and sacrifices for sin.
Now, listen what that says. Sometimes we trouble.
Yes.
We trouble and things that we shouldn't be troubled by. Read that again.
For every high priest taken from among men is ordained for men.
He ordained every high gift of taken from a man is ordained for men.
And things pertaining to God.
And things pertaining to God. You know, we are God's children.
Amen.
All of us. Yeah. The good, the bad, the ugly.
Amen.
Amen. Belong to God. God has no respect of person.
Thank you, God.
And you heard about that?
Yes.
He has no respect of person. Amen.
Amen.
And all the people that think he do, they got a problem. Read.
That he might offer both gifts and sacrifices for sin.
Look what he do. He's offering gifts and sacrifices for sin. Amen. I ain't coming for the good things that he done. We look at symbols a different way. We look at them a different way. We look at people that sin a different way. We need to see them the way God sin.
Yeah,
that is right.
That's right.
That's reading this word is so torn, twisted. Every man is his own way. He do things like he want to. Amen.
Yeah.
And if you read the book, starting, I think, in the book of Hebrews. No, not Hebrews. The seventh book of the Bible. What's the second book?
Exodus.
And they start talking about laws. Mm-hmm. Them people had laws way back then.
Mm-hmm.
They had laws that they had to abide by. They had laws that they have to concern themselves with. Amen.
Yeah.
God got laws.
Yeah.
Amen. They asked God, what is it? In other words, it's laws. But what is it?
Commandments.
The what?
Commandments.
Well, we use that word commandments. And God said, Jesus said, that you would love the Lord thy God with all your heart. Nothing missing, nothing broken, nothing back.
Yes.
Love the Lord thy God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and all your strength. Don't leave nothing out for your love for God. Don't leave nothing. And that you would put love thy neighbor as thyself. As somebody. Though they have you bought your neighbor a new car. That kind of shit them up. I could ask the question in here. Have anybody in here bought anybody a new car?
Yeah.
I'm in a new car, brand new, had 10 miles on it.
She sure did.
I'm still driving. Ain't got, and ain't got about 25,000 miles on it.
$15,000.
$15,000?
That's all.
You drive it on my dude. Amen. Love our neighbor as thyself. That's, is that hard for y'all to do?
No, sir.
Come on.
No, sir.
It ain't hard for your neighbors to do. It ain't hard for you to do. It ain't hard for you to bless your neighbor.
No, sir.
Well, I'm asking you to bless all these people who's leaving, going, and taking care of some business.
Amen.
I know how to shit people. You got to learn how to shit people. Bree Shirley.
Who can have compassion on the ignorant?
Who can have compassion, what?
On the ignorant.
On the ignorant. We criticize them.
What?
I was reading them. I ain't going to be up here long because, you know, I don't want to say this. Who can have compassion?
Yeah.
Can you have compassion over the ignorant?
Yeah.
We talk about them. Mm-hmm. We down them. We downtrodden. Amen. We don't want to give them nothing. We don't not want to give them encouragement. We want to give them. We don't definitely want to give them compassion. That compassion got a lot to go with it. Now we got one person in here. I know it's a very, very, very compact, well-to people. Sister,
Clapton?
Sister Clapton is one of the most compassionate people I have ever seen. She'll come up in a minute and ask you for money for somebody else. I say, what? I say, who you giving this to? Well, I'm giving it to some, you know. She's a compassionate person.
That's right.
It takes the heart of God to be compassionate.
You're talking about compassion. I need a person in the middle of you.
That's all right.
Like, we free here on Friday.
We need to know.
On Friday, this young man, student, came in my office and he said, can you check the film? He said, I was in the cafeteria and I lost my money.
Amen.
And
I said amen because I lost mine too, you too. I lost $600 out of my pocket. I mean, 1,200.
Yeah.
You're going to get it.
That's right.
Now watch this. Watch what happens.
Okay.
We checked the film, and it didn't look like it, nothing failed. But you can tell, the minute he walked out the cafeteria, about within 4 seconds, he turned around, and he came back, and he did like this. Mm-hmm. And I said, how much was it? Make a long story short. He said it was $30. He said, I have a little girl. And he said, and I borrowed that money from somebody, gave that to me so I can give my daughter some pampers.
Oh my God. Ooh.
And I said, really? He said, I don't know what to do. I'm just making a long story short. I went into my girl. And for whatever reason, I had went to the car earlier that, or about maybe a couple of hours ago, from a lost gig. I just grabbed it. Went back and everything, and I sold this out. So I just, I remembered that I had got my wallet. Pulled it out. I gave him 40. He just immediately started crying, said, "Stop crying." I said, "You're at the right place. You're at the right time."
People don't understand the spirit when it works.
Now watch this. Some say, "Give him 20 more." I gave him 20 more. He just bust out, just went to weeping. And he said, "You know what?" He said, "I'm gonna tell you something." He said, "My mom told me, I called my mom and told her I lost that money." Watch. And my mom told me, she said, "That's all right. You're gonna get back double." Seeing that boy, we have what? An opportunity.
Yes.
Let us do good unto who?
All men.
He told me, he said, "Coach," he said, "I turned my life around and I started going." He said, "I had just started going back to church last week."
Praise the Lord.
He said, "I just started going back to church last week." And he said, "What?" I said, and I said, "You know what?" I said, "You know what that was right there?" I said, "God just showed himself mighty on you."
Amen.
When we have compassion on people, we show God mighty in us. I just wanted to say, I love
you. Yeah,
so I'm telling you, that little money you just lost, you can give you double that.
All right. Amen.
And that one is $600. I mean, $1,200.
You're going to get double. I believe that. Now watch this. 30. He gave some what? 30, 60, and 100 fold. The same measure that ye meet,
it shall be met back to you.
Be met back to you. It's going to be met back to you again.
Amen.
You didn't lose it. You just misplaced it.
Okay.
Amen.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
Let's go.
Glory to God. We're talking about literary now. Compassion.
Compassion.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God.
Amen. We, I look around the church and I see, you know, people that possibly have compassion in hearts. And, it drives me to a place of compassion research.
And on them that are out of the way.
And on them that are out of the way.
For that he himself also is compassed with infirmities.
He talking about the man. The man. He compassed with Jesus went through some things.
Yes, he did.
But he stood fast. He stood in the blessing.
Amen.
The place of blessing. Mm-hmm. He stood in the place of compassion. Yeah. He stood in the place of he didn't move out of that place.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
He stood in the place of love.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah.
Thank
you, Lord. Amen. I don't care what happened to him. He still loves you.
Thank you, God.
Right. Come on, y'all.
Yes.
Jesus loved me, this I know.
Yes.
That's compassion.
Amen.
Father, the Bible tells me so.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Let the ones to him be Lord.
Yes.
Thou art weak, but he is strong.
Yes.
Strong.
Strong.
Everybody say strong.
Strong.
Jesus is strong.
Yes.
Jesus is strong.
Jesus is on my side. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
I ain't gonna lift my voice.
Yes.
Research.
And by reason hereof, ye oft ask of people, so also he himself to offer for sin.
Offer for sin.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
He didn't offer it for the good people had done.
No.
He offered it for the sin
yes.
that he committed. Now, you know, that lesson in itself, we condemn people that sin. And we already love them.
That is right.
Because we want them saved.
That's right.
We'll never get them condemning them. People will run from those us if we condemn them. I like that song, "He's Running After Me."
Amen.
Sing that verse. Do you love the Lord?
Do you love the Lord?
Yeah.
Yeah.
unto him that was a, unto him that was able to save him from death.
Hmm. All
and
right.
Heard,
amen.
And then he feared.
Read that again.
Who in the days of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and supplication with strong crying and tears unto him, that was able to save him from death, and was heard, and then he feared.
And it was heard. He was able. Everybody say he's able.
He's able.
Now y'all might not want to say this, but say I'm able.
I'm able.
Yeah. Amen. I'm able.
Yeah.
If you say that enough, you'll see it through creation.
Amen.
If you say it, I believe it. And if you say it till you believe it,
yeah,
it'll happen for you.
Hallelujah.
God is a good God.
God is a good God.